Ridge family. It's good to be with you this morning. I want to read some scripture just before we start talking this morning. Isaiah 40 says this: Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles, and they will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. You don't have to be faint today, right? You don't have to worry about tomorrow. God says he's going to rise us above, just like being on the wings of eagles. We're soaring above all this. God sees everything that's going on. So I want you to be at peace today. Don't worry about a thing. The future's coming, and I believe it's beautiful. God has some great things for us. So whenever you get a chance, read some scripture like this, just like it does for me. It brings just peace to my heart. And I think it's good for us daily to take some time, even though we're not together. Just take a few moments, open up scripture. God has some great things to say to us. And I think it brings such a sense of peace to me. And I know it will you also.
Yeah, that's great, John. Yeah. So sharing just a couple things that, you know, that are being sent out on the weekly email, but we just want to make you aware of them as well through the video here. I want to make a plug for some of the studies that are going on. So we recognize that people are getting a bit antsy and wanting to connect, and there are ways to connect, you know, online, through Zoom and through things like that. So some of the studies that are out there, so the study in the Gospel of Mark is still going on Mondays at 6:30 to 8. Rick and Elaine Beeble are leading that study. They're using Zoom for that. Also, the Women on Wednesday study, Galatians, is actually launching today, 6:30 to 8. Cindy Thompson is the point of contact for that. So it sounds like a great study through the book of Galatians. And then as well as the Connections class, it's been running Sunday mornings, normal time, 8:45. So if you haven't got enough of the sermons, if you're looking to talk more about the sermon, that's what they usually study is through the director, what I call the director's cut, which is basically just information I wasn't able to include on the sermon because of time, or it just didn't fit. So just some nice extra thoughts, and they talk about that and have some great conversations. So connect. Dan Bradley is the point of connection. If you're feeling like also like sharing life with others, but you're not maybe ready to, we're not ready to start getting together physically yet, one of the things I want to encourage you to do is to reach out to us on Facebook. So I got Mark sitting here, you can't see him, he's off camera, but he does such a great job with our Facebook page and the Facebook group. And so if you're looking to, I don't know, share a picture of what quarantine life has been like, share some joys, or you know, you can even share prayer requests on there, share a short video of just saying hi to folks. You might not think this, but when folks see your face, they're blessed by it. And it's also a nice encouragement just to share life, even if it is just a picture and a short post. We want to encourage you to reach out to us on Facebook, and I'm usually on there, and I'll probably be able to respond to that. And then the last thing I had for you was just, I was thinking about homecoming this week. Not homecoming in the sense of a dance, but homecoming in the sense of when you've been away from home for a while, and that sense of longing that you have, and the joy that you have in coming home. And as a prior military guy, as a prior Marine, I had a few of those in my life where I was distant, I was going through difficulty. That feeling of coming home is such a joy and a comfort. And what I believe one of the things that this quarantine is working for us to serve us is that when we come together finally as a church, I believe that that's just going to be a joyful homecoming occasion. And I also want to encourage you to think about that in terms of our heavenly homecoming. The struggles and the difficulties, the persecutions that we face in this life are really serving to us to increase our joy and our glory when we finally go home. And when there is a vast homecoming that is coming our way, scriptures tell us, a new heaven and a new earth. And that's just going to be joyful for us. So I want to encourage you with those words this morning. That. John, do you have anything else you want to
I just want to share, please connect with people. As Jeremiah has already mentioned to you, connect with people, because I find it just brings joy to my heart to see you and even just emails. If you can, don't be afraid of Zoom. A lot of our gatherings right now are on Zoom. It's pretty simple. You can look in our information on the website, figure out how to get in there. It's actually probably more simple than you think. But once you get in there, ladies, I see it sometimes. Maybe you didn't do your makeup, so you don't want to be seen. I'm not going to bring that up, but I guess I just did. You don't have to be seen. You could turn the audio on and just listen to people talk. And connect with your brothers and sisters is an awesome thing. So I encourage you to do that. Don't be afraid. As always, Pastor Jeremiah, myself, elders, a lot of people are just willing. They're just waiting for you to call. Right? So don't be afraid to do that. We would love to hear from you and connect with you. That's all I have.
All right, look, I would like to pray with you as we close. Gracious Father, we thank you for your words in 2 Corinthians that talk about that these light and momentary afflictions are accomplishing for us. They're working to serve us, to bring us, Lord, into deeper glory and to deeper joy. And so, Father, we thank you for the presence of your Spirit, Lord. We're not looking to just survive through this pandemic, Lord. We are wanting to thrive Amen. By the power of your Holy Spirit. We are wanting to thrive by the power of the Spirit of Christ that works mightily in us, Lord. And so, Father, we thank you for the great victory that we have in the blood of Jesus Christ and through the power of his resurrection. We give you praise, Lord, in the name of Christ. Amen. Amen. We love you. We
love you guys.
Boy, that's the story of my life. No respect. Tell her no respect.